Good morning, everyone. I'm meteorologist Matt Sir. We are seeing some sun. Isn't that awesome? Yeah, it's been so gray the last couple of mornings, and the fog is even clearing out way off to our west and east. This is the view from Highway 370 and 72nd in Papillion, and you can see that blue sky, maybe some wispy thin clouds across the metro right now. 31 at the airport as I shoot this a little after 10:15 this morning. South wind starting to pick up, and it feels like 21. There is a little bit of a wind chill, very little bit of a wind chill as we go into the afternoon, but it will feel so much nicer with the sun. As you can see, the low clouds, the fog dissipated around Carroll, thinning out even more around Columbus and Norfolk. So mostly sunny and breezy this afternoon. There is the storm system, the front that's going to bring the very quick burst of snow tomorrow morning. And this could come at the right time just to make the morning drive rough. I think should improve as we go into the afternoon, but it's going to get a lot colder tomorrow. Temperatures today, low to mid 40s around the Omaha Metro, some upper 40s possible down to the south. But again, those places that kept the fog a little bit longer, maybe Norfolk and Columbus hang closer to that 40 degree number, same toward Carroll, Atlantic, and Creston. So our computer model doesn't have a lot in the way of clouds through the morning. A couple more as we go into the afternoon. This evening, becoming cloudy, and we could have a little bit of drizzle come through late in the evening through about midnight. Temperatures still in the upper 30s, so we're not concerned about any type of slippery spots. This is what happens tomorrow morning. The front comes in, runs through by 3 o'clock. We're going to pick up northwest winds, and temperatures will be falling. So anytime between about 2 and 4 o'clock is when we're going to have the rain, possibly a rain-snow transition. And then by the morning drive tomorrow, here's 6 a.m., you can see that band of purple. That would be steady, possibly even heavy snow from Lincoln toward Omaha, back toward parts of western Iowa. This is going to come through. We're only going to get about 3, maybe 4 hours of snow at the absolute most. You can see it's already pushing toward Des Moines, toward Kansas City by 9 o'clock. And we might even see a little bit of sun with some strong winds tomorrow afternoon. The impacts, though, it's just the timing of it, I think, is going to have the biggest impact. 1 to 3 inches of snow, that's not a ton. Tiny chance that we see a little bit of sleet mixing in, going from rain to snow very early tomorrow morning. But the traveling, the roads early tomorrow morning, during the morning drive, will likely have the biggest impact. Still could have some isolated slippery spots in the afternoon. And the winds are going to be pretty blustery as well, gusting 25 to even 40 miles an hour. So blizzard conditions at times, not true blizzard conditions, because that needs to sustain for over 3 hours, or for at least 3 hours to get the official blizzard moniker. There are blizzard warnings in effect north of Des Moines. That's where they stand a better chance of maybe isolated 3 or 4 inch totals in that direction. But a lot of eastern Nebraska and western Iowa getting about 1 to 2 inches, maybe an isolated 3 inch total can't be ruled out. Less as you get closer toward the Kansas border, inch or less, Beatrice, Fairbury toward Falls City. So, no, not a lot of snow. It's just going to be with the strong winds and coming in during the morning drive, it's going to suck. There's no way to dance around it. Wind gusts tomorrow between 30 and 40 miles an hour, so it'll cause the low visibility in the morning. And then once the snow's out of here, we turn our attention toward the wind chill. Feels like temperatures tomorrow morning. As temperatures drop, it'll feel like the upper teens and low 20s. And then through the afternoon, generally, it'll feel like about 5 to 15 degrees with those winds. Friday's not too bad. Feels like temperatures, upper teens and low 20s. That's not bad for this time of year. And then we get the Arctic air to move in on Saturday. Saturday morning, wind chills 5 to 15 below zero. Sunday morning, 5 to 15 below zero. Monday morning, potentially 10 to 20 below. And we're going to actually have air temperatures below zero as well. So first we get the snow. That's coming in tomorrow. Not a lot, but it's enough that's going to make the morning drive take a little bit longer than usual if you are going to be headed out. We'll have you covered all through tomorrow morning. And then going into the weekend, the sub-zero temperatures and the bitterly cold winds, man, that's just going to be rough. And we could pick up another inch or two of snow on Saturday as that Arctic front swings through. So really not a lot in the way of snow, just unpleasant and some bitter cold in the forecast. We'll keep you covered over the next 24 hours with the snow and with the bitter cold going into the weekend. KETV.com, the free KETV mobile app. Meteorologist Sean Everson will have your forecast on NewsWatch 7 at noon, and Chief Meteorologist Bill Ramby will be in later tonight. And I'll see you tomorrow morning. It's going to be a busy morning on First News.